Friends, I have a information, and that information I want to share with you or with anybody who may be close to me or who may be far away. For that, I have established a technological system, and I will call that communication system. The main parts of that communication system, I have given certain nomenclature to it, and we must learn the basic parts. And after that, we will study how each and every part work, what are the different varieties in that, and what are the advantages, disadvantages, mechanism, and all other things which you will learn. So, here is a block diagram which tells us about a communication system, and we have to understand it. This portion, this box, is basically a communication or a transmission system. Okay, I have made this whole thing. The first block says we should have an information source. The information source, I am the information source, and if I want to talk to you, I need a microphone. So I, my voice, the microphone, this makes a information system. And from that microphone, what we receive is electrical signals that we will call signals. And what comes out of that, we have given it a name, and that name is message signal. So information source is the combination which gives you the information. The person who is performing, the instrument he is using, and other systems in that. So it may be another example, it may be a camera. So it is a camera, it is the light picture, and when we click it, that camera converts it into electrical signals which goes out from the camera. So this camera, the person who is performing before the camera, and the light, all this makes information system, information source. Okay, and what comes out from there is message signal. Now, this message signal, what happens to it? It goes to our communication system. In that communication system, the first thing we have is transmitter. The microphone has made a voltage. My sound is converted to electrical voltage, and such machines which convert it, we will study it, that is known as transducer. Okay, so a transducer is the microphone which converts my sound into electrical current variations, signals. Okay, now these signals, if I put it on a conductor, on a line, and send that conductor to 500 kilometer, and there I put a speaker, the sound will not come there because of the resistance. It will die away on its way. So I had to do certain modifications. So a machine, a system which modify my voice, give its strength to those electrical signals, so that those electrical signal can go to a very, very large distance. That mechanism which is giving strength is known as transmitter. Okay, so transmitter is the one which is on from one end receiving the message signal sent by microphone, sent by camera or anything. That transmitter receive it, and then it makes it strong. It makes it strong. Strong for what? Strong for traveling. So when it becomes strong, it sends out the strong signals, what we call them, transmitted signal. See the difference, message signal, transmitted signal. This is the difference. And these signals are now sent. How these strong signals are sent? There are three methods of sending it. We can send it on the wire, twin wire, okay, or we can send it, I should divide it into two parts. One, I can send it on the material wire, that is the voltage variations or the electric current is sent on a conducting wire. That is one method. And that conducting wire goes to, that material wire goes to 100 kilometer, 500 kilometer, 1000 kilometer, wherever I want to send it. The other method is I convert this strong signal into electromagnetic waves, and then I don't need that material wire. With the help of antenna, I will transmit it, and that will, electromagnetic waves will have resonance with another antenna, and there we call it, they are brought down. But I can send it by two methods. If I send it on the wire, that is material medium. Other is space medium, no material medium. So this medium which I am taking help for sending, whether it is material or whether it is wireless, with wire or wireless, this medium in my communication system will be known as channel. So what means by channel? Channel is the medium. So if I send it on optical fiber, I will say my channel is OFC, optical fiber cable. My channel is wire. My channel is wireless transmission. So these are the channels. That means the medium on which signal is transmitted to faraway place. Now the signals have gone to faraway place. When the signals reach there and I receive it, now the signals I am receiving, I change its name. For me, it is received signal. For this transmitter, it is transmitted signal, and for a receiver, I am here, I will say it is a received signal. I receive the signal through antenna of the radio, antenna inside my mobile, dish antenna, or simply a optical fiber which is coming, or any two wire system which is coming carrying the signal. All these will carry what? A signal, and where I receive in this machine, that is known as receiver. Now what to do with that? This signal has got two parts. One is the message signal which was originally given by information source. Another thing, we have made it very strong with help of transmitter. Here I will give you a small analogy. Like, I want to go to my house in London. I cannot walk, it's far away distance. So I want to go, I am a message signal, but I am very weak, I cannot go. So what do? I go to a person, I tell him I want to go, and I please set up mechanism for me. What he will do? He will prepare a setup for me in which I am given an air ticket, I am prepared for air travel, and I am given a seat in the aeroplane. This is, who is doing this? Answer, transmitter is doing it. I am information source. What I give out? A message signal, I want to go. Who is my transmitter? The airport authority, the aeroplane, and that complete system is a transmitter system. They convert me to an air passenger sitting in an aeroplane. Alternatively, if it would have been Mumbai or some other place, they would have put me in rail compartment. In that case, my transmitter would have been a railway system. If I want to go to London, then it is a airport system. That is my transmitter. So what does that transmitter has done? It has given me strength so that I can fly, so that I can go to a long distance. This is giving strength. Okay, that is the job of transmitter. Then what is the channel? If I am going by train, rail is the channel. If I am going by aeroplane, air is the channel. That is the channel. Now, I come to London Airport. The aeroplane comes to London Airport. But I have to go to my house. Can I go to my house along with my aeroplane? Along with the seat of the aeroplane? Along with everything? No. So there has to be a system which will separate me from the aeroplane. There has to be a system which will separate me from the train if I am going by train. So I leave the train there, I leave the airport there, everything there, and I come out. Who has received me? My house or the airport? Answer, airport has received me. He is receiver. Because he has received me as well as the complete system of aeroplane which has made me strong to fly. With a railway station which has a railway system which has received the railway along with me. I am part of that rail system which has received me. But I cannot carry that train to my house. I have to leave it there. So this receiver, what does it do? It separates train compartment from me, and now I am alone and I come to my house. The same thing happens with my signal. Like I have sung a song. So this song with microphone is converted into voltage variations. These voltage variations are very low voltage. Okay? Vibrations frequency is very low and it has got very low power. It will not go to a long distance. So we take help of a transmitter. It gives it a very high frequency. It adds a very high frequency. This is my low frequency signal. It will envelop it. Now this whole thing has become a strong, capable of going a long distance signal. That job is done by the transmitter. Now it is thrown either by wireless method or by material wire method. That method is known as channel. Now here is the station where somebody wants to receive it. So he is receiving it with help of an antenna. After receiving, he receives this package. He has to remove it. So this machine has got a system. What is that system? Number one, it is capable of receiving the bundle of the message signal as well as the transmitted signal. So this machine has a capability of resonance tuning, which we have already studied. With the help of that tuning and message, it received the signal, this one. Now from this signal, what does it do? It separates out this much, this strong one, and this, the message signal which was stored in this, that is given to a speaker, and the speaker sings because it has received the original message. Now if this machine is not there, it will not tune, it will not receive, and it will not separate it. What will you listen? A shoo sound, which is not intelligent. So that is receiver, which does the tuning, separation of the high frequency, and gives us the information, and here we play the information. So these are the basic parts of a transmission system. So we will see them one after the other in details. There are different varieties in the sources, in the messages, in the transmitters, in the channels, in all that. Yes, one small thing we have to learn, and that is noise. What is noise? Noise is a message signal, but it does not carry any message. What does that mean? I am going on a train, so many people comes up which are not desired. They come without ticket, without reservation, came in, I can't help. That is noise. So unwanted signals which are coming. When you listen a song, you say there is a lot of noise, shoo, shay, background noise, all these were not required, these were not recorded. If these were not recorded, these were not there, how they came in? Answer is, they get mixed up at which stage? Channel state. Because channel, through the channel, we are going the long distance, that 100 kilometer, that 1000 kilometer is channel. in that if somebody is doing on the way, if somebody is doing welding on the road, he is creating electromagnetic waves. Those electromagnetic waves are picked up by my packet which is going here. And then when we open it and send it there, we find that that click click noise is there. This is because it was carried on by channel. It has a nature to take these frequencies or the signals along. That is noise. So what is noise? Unwanted signals. Okay, we will come to those definitions one after the other. So this is basically the complete system. Now out of this, this is the signal which information has given. This is the signal which is required. This in between part, this to this, this is basically communication system where we have a transmitter, there is a channel and there is a receiver. This is known as transmitter. From here we fit a microphone or a camera. Here we fit a speaker or a screen monitor. It will come there. So these are the basic box diagram of the communication system, and we are using so many terms in this. We are using signal, channel, and I have shown you there is modulators, demodulators, and there are so many other things which we are going to use in this, transducer, antennas. So in the next lecture, some very useful terms we will try to learn. What does that mean? Because those we are going to use again and again in our communication system, and you should understand what does that mean, what is the variety of those things, and where to use it and where not to use it. Another important thing I wanted to tell you, the types of communication, types. We have categorized this communication in two categories. One, when I want to talk to you and nobody else should listen to it. Only we two be in talking. That is, we do a telephone to you. I am doing a telephone to you. So I am one point, you are the other point. These two points are connected to each other. So we call this type of communication as point to point. Point to point communication. Example, telephone. I am speaking, but only you are listening. Nobody else is listening. Nobody else. Then it is point to point. In other case, I am speaking on the TV. Anybody who tunes the TV is listening to me. So, one speaker, one signal is sent, but the receivers are many, public, what we call it. This is also a communication, but this communication we have given it a name and we will call it broadcast. You all know this word? Broad, wide, cast, sending. So the broadcast means one sender, many, receiver, and this is free to anyone. This is broadcast. Anybody who wants to listen it can listen it, like we tune the radio, we tune the TV. That is. So the communication has two types, point to point and broadcast. Thank you.